Hi guys, I have a new printable. It's a template printable, and it makes a 6x9 envelope mini album or junk journal or whatever you want to call it. There are 12 pages, I think, yes. And this one's kind of cool because you get the blank templates and then you also get your choice of a pattern template. And I'll show you what I'm talking about as I flip through. But basically, this template, you print it out on whatever paper you want and cut it out and fold it and do whatever you do to make your pretty little mini journal. So what's really unique about this, like I said, you can print it on whatever you want. So you can take your favorite patterned paper and print it out and cut it out. You can do it that way. You can print it out on white cardstock. You can print it out. I'll show you all the options here in a little bit. So let's just start by showing you the templates. Like, here is the 6x9 envelope. This is part one, and then this is part two. So you cut these out and you fold them and glue them together, and then you have, let me find one I already put together here. Whoops, sorry. Then you have a 6x9 envelope that is open on one on both ends with a flap. So this is pattern cardstock. Like I said, you can print it out, you cut your 12 by 12 pattern cardstock down to 8.5 by 11, and keep your pieces because you can use those as tags and stuff. And then you just choose which template you want to print and print it out right onto the pattern cardstock. Okay, so anyway, so this is actually 6x9. So that's those two templates right there. Oh, and I also wanted to point out the templates themselves come with the brown vintage distressed edge, but you can also set your printer to print black and white and then it'll print out black. So technically you get two sets of templates, or three, because you get a patterned one as well. Which I'll explain in a minute. So that's a really nice option. So those that don't have colored printers, you can still use this template with just the black and white, and you can use your favorite pattern paper, because we all have that pattern paper at home that we need to use, or it's our favorite, you know, and we're not sure what we want to do with it. Well, you can print right out on top of it. All right, so there's the envelope. And then this one is actually for matting the envelope. Let me open this one up to show you. I printed the envelope out onto craft cardstock. See there? And then these are the mats. If you wanted to do it that way, just print it out on plain cardstock and mat it. Those are the three pieces. This can also be a page. It can also mat any other part of the, you know, the insides there. So there's the mats, and then this one right here is a double page. Well, it's not a double page. It's a double clasp envelope. So once it's assembled and you put it in your signature, you know, there's going to be one on each side with the flap, you know, in the clasp part. So that's fun. I'll have to show you all that in a little while. And here's an envelope that you cut out, and then these are either pages or inserts, of course both, whichever. They will fit into just about every, you know, nook and cranny. They'll fit into here, they'll fit into the envelope, they'll fit into there's other pockets and things, but they'll fit into just about everything. So those are inserts. And then here is a mini clasp envelope, and there's some inserts for hold on, let me find it. Those are inserts for this mini envelope right here. And then there's a pocket that you attach to your blank pages. And there's another pocket. And then that insert there, I am pretty sure that goes into this pocket right here. So that's the insert for that. And it can also be a page. This is a page pocket, so you cut it out and you fold that up to make a pocket. And here is a side pocket, so that's a bottom pocket and then a side pocket. Depending on which way you print it out or how you fold it, depending on which way the, you know, the pocket is. Oh, and then here is the different patterns that you can choose from. What do I got back here? Oh, I wanted to show you the reason, I wanted to tell you the reason why I'm doing the patterns as well as with the blank templates is because sometimes you have a white back on a printed cardstock, or let's say you're just using plain cardstock, a colored cardstock, and you wanted to put a little bit of pattern on it. This is perfect for that. So here's the first one. It's a doily. I think it's just one sheet. Yeah. So what I did, I wanted to show you, because I printed this on the back side of this purple cardstock, purple patterned paper. So I printed the doily on the back side in black. Isn't that pretty? So it looks like it was meant to be that way with very little effort. So I wanted to show you, I wanted to explain that. Okay, so there's a doily, which is really pretty. It's really vintagey. And then there's a collage sheet. Oh, my lighting is not very good today. A collage sheet. There are music notes. There is a watermark. There is text paper. There's splats, which are pretty cool. And then there's old paper, old crinkly paper. So those are the, I think there's seven background patterned parts that you can choose from. So you get a set of whichever pattern you choose and a set of the blank templates when you purchase the listing. I also wanted to tell you that these are, this is all printed on 8.5 by 11. Let me move this out of the way. So this one is using an 8.5 by 11 piece of a patterned cardstock. Well, my printer, you can, there it is. You can also print the A4 paper size. You just have to change the setting in the printer. So that's a thought too, if you wanted to try to do, if you have these patterns, you know, these Prima seems to be doing a lot of this size. Excuse me. But yeah, it'll go right through, and let me show you the difference between the 8.5 by 11 and the A4 size. You have to customize it to fit or whatever, shrink to fit. But look, there's just 1/4 inch on the top and a little over 1/8 inch on the side. But that's using this paper, so I printed it out on this paper, and I printed it out black instead of the brown. But yeah, so look, you can use all your printed cardstock, printed patterned paper, which is pretty cool, I think. Okay, so I just wanted to show you that really quick. All right, now I want to show you all the different options you have to print out. So what I did was I printed the same thing, the doily pattern, on everything that I'm going to show you with the pocket, the side pocket. So I just wanted to show you, you know, the difference. So they all look the same, so you can see how it prints on each thing. So this is obviously just white cardstock, and it, you know, prints. This is the only one I actually went back and inked, but then I stopped and said, no, don't do that. So this is on white cardstock. This one is on patterned paper, of course. And you can't really see the doily. It's like it's just a suggestion. It's really pretty. So if you put it on top of your pattern paper, it'll still be kind of cool looking. Nope. Hold on just a minute. Whoa. Okay, and this is coffee-stained paper that I ran through the printer. Pretty cool, right? You kind of want to make sure you pick the ones that are the flattest or iron them flat before you send them through your printer. And you may want to test your printer on, you know, all this different stuff before you start printing out the whole thing. And then here's vellum. It's kind of hard to see the vellum. But it actually printed out really nicely and folded. And I just used double-sided sticky tape, and you can't even really tell to make the pocket. So there's vellum. There's craft cardstock. Pretty cool. This is a transparency, which I thought was also pretty stinking cool. Colored cardstock, right? And then this one is really neat, and I think I'm gonna explore this a little further. This is mixed media, 140-pound mixed media paper. So I cut it down to 8.5 by 11, and then I changed the settings in my printer so that it knew that it was an extra heavy duty type cardstock. And I ran it through, and if you have a laser printer, I'm betting you can do all kinds of decorative things on here, like watercolor and that kind of stuff. I think that's a pretty neat idea to make a little art journal out of this template. So that's pretty exciting. So that's all I can think of right now on things that you can print on. But I'm guessing anything that you can send through your printer, you can print these out on. So, okay, I wanted to show you that. Oh, and this is neat. I've already printed everything out. And the way I suggest you do it is you start with the envelope. So you need to decide, do I want to use just a plain white cardstock, or do I want to print it out on the pattern paper? And then you want to do it like what belongs together. So what I mean by that is you pick your paper because, okay, this is part of the envelope, obviously. And then, this one I printed on the back side of the paper like that because I'm going to mat it. So this paper will be like the flat part. All you'll really see is the flat part, but then I'm going to ink it and mat it with other pattern paper. So those parts are the envelope, and then here's the mats. Now, I don't know if you notice or not, but see all that gold foiling on there? Well, my printer printed over top of it. I was surprised. I would not. Here's the paper line that I'm using. It is Blush Glam by Craft Smith, I think. Yep. And it's pink, and it's got this gold all throughout the paper, and my printer printed over top of it. Now, I would not suggest printing over top of anything glittery because that could gunk up your printer. But again, I suggest you try one piece and see what happens. All right, so I got my base and my envelope here, and then there's the mats. So I did a little test. Where'd it go? Here it is. This is what it ends up looking like. So these are the mats, and then there's the back side there. I inked it up, and then let me get this. Well, that's just two little brads there. And so there's the inside. So that's what it's going to end up looking like. See, the pink is on the inside there. All right, so when I chose the papers, I put these three together. Okay, these three need to coordinate together. So that's how I printed those out. And then here I printed out inserts that'll go on either side of these, of the envelope, of the pockets. So that's for that. And then here's the envelope. So when I picked out the envelope, I printed out inserts that would go inside the envelope next. So that's what I did there. And then here is the, let me show you in my prototype. This is my prototype. The designs are not complete in here, so I don't want you to get confused in any way. But this page right here, it was before I added the clasp, but here it is right here. There's one side of it, okay? And then the other side is over here. So it'll go together and look just like a half of a clasp envelope inside of your 6x9 envelope, mini journal or art journal or travel journal or junk journal, whatever you want to call it. So there's the two pieces for that. So I made sure they looked good together because this will be, on the back side there, and the flap will be over top of it. Okay, so you kind of getting my gist here. And then I printed out some inserts for that envelope. Like I told you, these could be pages or inserts. They fit almost everything. And then here is a large envelope. I already printed one of these out, didn't I? Yes, I did. But I'm going to put one of these large envelopes inside this double clasp page. I don't know what to call it. And so then I also printed out inserts for that. Right, it's pretty clever. And then look at all that gold. Goodness gracious. Look at it. Okay, so there's the smaller clasp envelope, and then the inserts that go in this envelope. So I made sure that when I printed this one out, that it matched okay with the inserts. And then these are the inserts for this envelope. So the pockets, I wasn't really concerned about. I can put those anywhere. So I was just more concerned about matching these up. I hope I'm making sense. I'm probably not, but I hope I am. And then here is the bottom pocket page, and then the side pocket page. So I didn't really print out anything to go inside of them because we got all kinds of scraps left over. Like, here's my pile of scraps that when I cut everything down to 8.5 by 11. Well, so we can do a lot with that. So we don't want to waste that. So I didn't want to print too much. Okay, I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and cut everything out and come back and show you how to assemble them. You really don't need to sit and watch me cut all this stuff out. So we'll be right back. Okay, I got everything cut out. I want to start with obviously the 6x9 envelope, how to put it together first. So there's the part one that I printed on the back side of the pattern paper. So this is going to be the outside, and then these are going to go as like photo mats for it. Okay, so the first thing after you cut it out is you want to kind of like prep these little flaps here. And you know, I like to take my ruler, my bone folder, and like do a little bit of a score line. It just folds easier, especially long folds like that. Just makes it easier. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that. I'm even gonna do this top flap right here. Okay, so then what you wanna do, just go ahead and prep it before you put the tape on it. I would suggest you using a really strong double-sided tape, but you can use liquid glue if that's all you have. And you kind of want to make sure that it's going to fit too, because I wasn't real careful about cutting everything out, so it might not be exact. I think I did pretty good. So I'm going to be using this Suquain score tape, double-sided score tape here. And I'm just going to put it on these flaps, these little tab things, just like this. Where's my scissors? Whoa. There's a light right there I keep bumping into, in case y'all haven't figured that out yet. Alright. You don't have to be that neat about it with your tape. You can just tear it. But I like to be a little bit neat. So just apply the tape on there. Burnish it down. And then you want to go ahead and ink this top edge first before you put it together. And then remove your tape from one side. You can start from the top or the bottom, either one. You just want to line it up as best you can. If it's not perfect, it's fine. It's not going to hurt anything. But it looks like I did a pretty good job. All right, so you do the one side. And then you want to come back and do the other side. Shoot, there we go. And it should just fold right on over. Just like that. I did pretty stinking good. There's a little bit of an overhang. You're probably not going to be able to see it, no matter where. There it is, just a little bitty bit. But the ink will definitely hide that. Okay, before I go, I'm going to ink this inside. I'm going to turn the flap backwards, and I'm going to ink this right here so that it stands out a little bit more. Okay. I need a new thingy for my blending tool. Alright, and then fold it the right way. And then you want to go ahead and ink all these edges. You don't have to ink them. That's why they're already pre-distressed. Besides the fact that it's the template for you. It's so that if you didn't want to, you don't have to ink them. Or you can be uber careful about your cutting them out and everything. Okay. All right, so I've already got these. Oh, you know what I got before I put that on. Obviously, that's a 6x9 envelope, obviously, right? Then you want to gently fold up the one side to almost, but not quite, meet that score mark right there. And you want to push that down really good, and you want to make sure you really give that a good burnish. Flip it over. Because you want it to have, you know, you want it to be to you where you have like a book. You fold it over in half. Ink those edges. You can ink the inside too if you want to, but I don't think I've done that yet. All right, so here's the way my book's going to fold. Just like that. This is going to be the front. It's going to fold, the flap is going to come over on the right side. So when I open it up, I want to have it this way because I want, since this has wording, I'm going to make sure it's right side up. And I'm going to start with this flat piece. You can use whatever glue you have, whether it's liquid or dry, it does not matter. Not for this anyway. So I'm going to use Fabri-Tac by Beacon. It gives you time to move it around, but it also holds on pretty quick. I like that. And, you know, I wanted to point out too, I don't know if it's noticeable anymore, but when I glued these on, you probably can't really tell. This one was put on with Fabri-Tac, and this one was put on with tacky glue, and it worked where the tacky glue was. I guess because it's wetter. Is that the right way to say that? Wetter? All right, so I'm just going to center it on here to where there's about an eighth of an inch all the way around. Just like that. And then the next piece is this one. So you'll see that this part right here is slightly bigger than this part. Even though these two are the same size, you're just going to have to be a little bit more careful when you're centering this one from side to side. All right. I'll show you what I mean here in a second. And you really don't need that much glue. Unless, of course, you're putting mixed media paper on here and it needs to be watertight. Okay, so you eighth of an inch on top and the bottom, but the sides are going to be a little bit more than an eighth of an inch. Plus, you can kind of, you know, easily match up these lines. You see what I mean there? See how there's just a little bit more than an eighth of an inch right there? Boy, my lighting is terrible. I'm so sorry. And then this last piece. And it gets an eighth of an inch all the way around. It should, anyway. Did I say I'd already inked these mats before I turned the camera back on? I did that just so that it saves some time. Oops, took off some of the design. Whoops, sorry, hello! All right, so you see how that one is an eighth of an inch, where this one's a little over an eighth of an inch. It's really no big deal. It's not going to hurt anything. So when it folds up, it's going to look like this, right? That's pretty cool, right? All right, so there is the base of the 6x9 mini album, junk journal, what have you. And then here is a couple inserts. I am pretty sure these are meant to go here in the sides. So what I did was I folded it in half and then trimmed it because they're going to be double-sided. I would normally glue it together first before I trim it, but I wanted to have everything trimmed out before I turn the camera back on. And then you want to ink the edges. And And the same thing again applies. If you don't trim it out just perfect, it is fine. I'm getting so many little thingies. Yeah, so these were meant to go in here. So what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to wait to ink them until later, but I'm going to just go ahead and stick them there even though I'm not ready for them. All right, the next thing is this envelope. And the way it goes together is, well, you know what, I'm going to, since this paper has got that gold foiling, it doesn't like to fold pretty, it doesn't like to fold very good on its own. So I'm just going to give it a little help, especially on flaps for some reason. See, that is so much nicer. Those are the flaps. And then this one should fold up just nicely. Like so. And then the top flap here. Whoa, come back here. Just like that. And so before you glue it together, you want to make sure you ink this edge and this edge, these two edges right here, and this edge. So I'm going to do that real quick. And then I'll just show you the stuff you need to ink before you put stuff together, and then I'll come back and ink everything without you all having to be tortured by it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to run some glue along this edge right here and along this edge right here. Don't go all the way to the top on this because it doesn't go, the bottom flap doesn't go all the way to the top. Whoops, I got some glue in the wrong spot. What is going on here? Okay, so you just, okay, camera shut off. So I'm not sure why, but okay, so you, I don't know where it stopped, so I folded it up and glued it, and then you would ink this edge all the way around, all, you know, the, both sides. So there's the envelope, and then here are the two inserts that are going inside that envelope. So same thing, you just want to cut them out and glue them. So of course I will ink these up at some point, but not right now. Just make sure there's no glue on the outside. And I'm gonna stick them right in here, just like this. They both go in there, but you don't have to put them both in there. They can be a page if you wanted them to be. All right. I'm thinking one of these envelopes is supposed to be my center envelope. I don't think it's this one. Let me double check here. No, this one, the reason I made this envelope, because I put it off too, remember, is to go up here on this, in that pocket there. So far we got those two pockets full. All right, next up is this piece, this double clasp page piece. This is super simple. I know it looks crazy, but you see these notches right here? You need to make sure that you go just a little bit past the actual distress template part there. Just past the brown line or the black line, whichever way you print it out. And then I'm going to take my folder, my bone folder and my ruler. And I'm going to score these flaps because these will be hard to do without doing this. These little skinny flaps. Just like that. And then you just want to fold them over. Okay, and the only thing you have to ink before you glue it all together is this inside part, if you wanted to ink it at all. And then, let's see, I got to itch my arm itches. I'm also going to score this mark here, the center mark, like this, because this is going to end up folding this way. Well, I guess it doesn't have to. It could probably fold the other way, depending on how you put it in your book. All right, the same with this. I'm going to do the score mark right here in the middle. And I'm going to go ahead and do these little flaps too while I got it out. Okay. And I'm going to use my score tape again. And I am going to put it on these flaps. This is just so exciting for me, this idea, this template idea. You know how many different looks you can get from the same template. I mean, it's endless. Every paper line is going to look different with the same, you know, template, and depending on what you do with it and how, I don't know. I'm so excited about it. I can't hardly stand myself. That's what I tell my husband. He just laughs at me. All right, you want to fold this. Like I said, it didn't even occur to me, but I guess you could fold it the other way and it could go into the signature. We're going to have one signature, so it could go into this, you know, and have the flaps on the outside of the page. But I'm going to leave mine like this. So what we're going to do is we're going to attach it down just like that. So it'll be a double clasp envelope on each side. So we're going to start with one side first, and then we'll do the other. And the reason I cut that notch out is it took the bulk away from there. It took the bulk out of the bend. Bulk out of the bend? Yeah, that sounds good. Bulk out of the bend. The bulk out of the seam. Something like that. Okay. So I got this one first. I think I'm going to do it like this. You just want to kind of line it up before you press anything down and maybe fold it over a little bit on itself. And then, whoa. Come on. It's not as hard as it looks, I swear. And then, well, line up those edges there. Oh, I got off a little bit, but that's okay. That's what ink is for. And then tie the other side. Oh, I keep trying to put that over there. Can't seem to hold it the right way to show you. I'm trying. Okay. So that's all good and down. And see, it folds up on itself like that. And we hit, isn't that cute? And the little pink flap with the little polka dots. I just love it. So cute. I like polka dots. They're kind of one of my favorites these days. All right, so there's that double pocket. You would obviously ink the inside here, ink all around the edges. So that's it for that, and that would be, this is, you know, how it would sit in the book. So you would have, you know, pockets on each side, or you could fold it out the other way, you know, and have it that way. Okay, and then the inserts for that are, once again, just these. Oh, and I cut it, the 12 by 12 cardstock out so that that would be on one of the inserts. Isn't that cute? So pay attention to what kind of pattern you have on your cardstock to see, you know, if you want to pick, make sure you pick out a certain area that'll print it. Oh, another quick tip. I probably should have shared this with you earlier. Hold on. Let me finish this and then I'll go get my other quick tip I was going to tell you about. I'm gonna pause the camera and I will be right, but let me put these in here first and then I'll be right back. So those go in there. I don't wanna confuse the inserts with what I picked out for what, because I do that. A little extra glue seeping out. And I get carried away with my glue too. And see, this paper's kind of got like a polka dot on it, so it kind of coordinates pretty good. It's one thing about using a pad of paper. That way you know for sure that it's going to all match together. All right, hang on. I'll be right back. Okay, what I wanted to tell you, one of the tips I was going to give you earlier and I forgot, is go ahead and print yourself out one of each one of the templates so you'll have it on hand when you go to pick out your pattern cardstock. And before you cut your pattern cardstock. So, for example, this pattern won't matter, so you just cut it down. I always cut it to the smallest length that I possibly can first. So the 8.5 would be first, and then the 11. But that pattern really doesn't matter much. Let's see if I can find one. Oh, here's one. If you, if you wanted your chevrons to go up and down on the page, which is kind of the way I like it, you're going to want to make sure that you cut it 8.5 by 11 instead of 8.5 by 11. Because when it folds up, you know, that'll determine which way your direction is. So it's helpful to say, I'm directionally challenged, so I get messed up all the time. So it's helpful to have these. So like, okay, once this prints out, it's going to go through the printer like this, and I mean, you see what I'm saying? That way you know, you don't get confused, because I waste a lot, I don't waste it because I use it for stuff, but I waste a lot of time printing out the wrong direction of stuff. So that was just a quick tip I wanted to give you real quick. Okay, on to putting together. Oh, I've already put together this envelope. Okay, yes. I'm glad I realized what I was doing before I messed up. This envelope is going to go into the center of the signature so that the stitch will be hidden. You don't have to do that. It's just something I like to do. So you want to do everything except glue it together. So it's the same way as the other one. Okay. Next up is these two pieces, the pocket and then the mini envelope. I went ahead and scored these two flaps, these three flaps, and these two right here. Well, I was gone just for a minute. I'm not going to attach this to anything yet, but you just, you know, fold these things over, score them, or burnish them, just like that, and then it's ready to be attached to any page in your journal. And then this one is just like the big one. It's just like this big one. I went ahead and got this all inked up and ready to go. This is going to be my center, remember? So you start with these little flaps right here. I scored those two, but I don't think... Oh, yep, I scored that bottom piece too, even though I don't think you really need to. Just like that. And fold the top over. And of course, you want to ink certain edges before you glue, because it'll be harder to get to them once it's glued together. Oops, what I did with my glue. Here it is. And the same thing with this one. So you want to run just a little bit right here, and then just a little bit on this edge right there. And then you just fold it up, just like that. Where are the inserts for this one? Let's see. I believe these two right here are the inserts. These go in here, just like that. These printed off with this smaller clasp envelope. So these go in here. You don't have to put both of them. And these papers are not double-sided, so I'll have to ink the back of these. But these go in here, and then these can go in like one of the pockets or something. I'll ink that up off camera as well. And then let's do this pocket. Now this one I only scored right here on this little flap right there. I only pre-scored it so because that's so skinny. But the rest of it should fold up really nicely because of the cuts and stuff. So this one, oh, maybe not. It depends on the paper too. So I guess this cardstock with the foil once again doesn't want to do that as easily. So then you want to match up the edges just like that. And this one has a bottom that folds up, unlike the big covers, the 6x9 envelope. It just has a faux bottom because it's open for to be a pocket. And then you flip that top down like that. And there we go. Now we need to ink this inside edge right here. And we need to ink this little flap right there. And so what you want to do is you want to put glue here on this flap, the skinny flap. Fold it over. Give it a press. Aren't these cute? Why are mini things so cute? It's like a little baby. Every baby animal in the world is adorable. I don't care what it is. All right, and then you want to glue this bottom flap down. You really only need glue to go along the bottom edge there. You just want to hold it for a second and get any seepage. Just like that. And this can go into any pocket. Like it could go into these pockets here when you attach them to something. It could go into the bottom pocket or the side pocket or whichever pocket. Where's the inserts for that? It's right here. And this one was printed off with another extra pocket. So all you gotta do is fold it over and glue it. Of course, ink the edges if you want, which I'll do off camera. Ooh, look, I didn't fold that one very good. See, I missed it. I missed it, but that's okay. Once I ink it, I'll never know. And that fits in there like that. So I'll ink that in a minute. And then you already see me fold this one, but I'll fold it again. These two pockets are exactly the same. I mean, you can't have too many pockets, right? So, and it's nice that they match, like the whole idea with the swoop and stuff. And all right, here is the one that has the bottom pocket. So all I've scored this line, and this line already. So I guess I scored them all. So you want to flip these over like that. And then, you know, you can also do it the other way. If you printed it on the back side, or even if you didn't print it on the back side, you could flip these this way and flip it up that way too. So, but I'm going to do it like this. Flip those in and then flip that up just like that. Give it a burnish and then fold it over just like that. Right? And the only thing that you need to ink before you glue it down are just those edges right there. You can use double-sided tape if you would like, or just plain old wet glue. There we go. Give that a second to tack. And then ink all the edges. See, like this little dude right here can fit in here as well. So can this. It can fit in here too. So everything kind of is interchangeable, which is cool, I think. Anyway. All right, and here's the side pocket. So I've already scored these two flaps like that. And then I'm going to fold it up. I didn't score this line because these fold pretty easily. Well, I said that about the other one too, but so you fold that like that, and then you bring it up to match it up with that other side, and it should be just perfect, just like that. So there's the pocket. You want to ink this edge first before you glue. So put glue on each one of those flappy doos, and then close her up. Hold it for a second. Okay, I'm going to ink everything up that I just put together, and then I will be back. Okay, I've got everything all inked up and ready to go, and I've arranged them in the order in which I want to put them in here. And the way I'm going to do the binding is I'm going to do the three-hole pamphlet stitch. This is probably the easiest way to bind a book like this, the simplest, the fastest. And I'm just going to use the seam binding as the closure as well to tie it around. Okay, so the first thing I want to do is I want to get it all. There's my envelope that's going to be in the center, so the middle part's going to be hidden. So I made sure I got that in there, and I want to make sure that I've got it exactly where I want it. Then I'm going to use these clips, hopefully, I'm going to use these clips to hang on to it while I poke holes in the center there. Something's not looking just right. Okay, let me put it on this side as well. Aren't these cute little gold clips? I think they are. Okay. And if it ends up being off a little bit, well, it's off a little bit then. You know, with the, if it's not directly hitting the center. So you just want to take a ruler and you want to find the center. So it's 6 inches tall. So we're going to go right smack in the middle. And then we're going to go at 2 inches, which is an inch from the bottom, and 2 inches, which is an inch from the top. We're going to mark it, and we're going to go through all of these layers at one time. So this is going to take a little bit of, maybe not. This is just a two pieces of fun foam, a thick fun foam that I glued together. I didn't. That wasn't too bad. So I got that hole poked. And the hole poked. Well, look at there. I thought it was going to be harder. I don't even know my own strength. All right. All three holes are poked. And then I'm going to use a matching seam binding, which I believe this pink right here will be perfect. So I'm just going to pull out, I'm not sure how much I'm going to need. I'm going to pull out from tip to tip, from fingertip to fingertip, stretched across there, and see how much, and see if that'll, I probably shouldn't have cut it off. It's probably not going to be enough, and I'm going to be mad. Okay, so you want to get a needle that you can thread the seam binding on. Let me scooch that. And you want to start from the outside because you want to be able to wrap it around. So this needle is actually blunt. I don't know if you can tell that there it's not sharp. I mean, it'll still hurt you if you poke through there. Now this is the part that's going to be trying to get this big fat eye of a needle. I don't know if you can tell. Can you see it now? Yeah, there you go. Through this little hole that's been poked. Hang on. Gonna have to get something to grab it and pull it. I'm gonna get a pair of pliers. I need to be careful so I don't knock the camera off or. Okay, so I pulled it through the one hole, and then you can go either to the top or the bottom, either one. And then you wanna go back to the outside there. There we go. Then you want to go, I'm going to have to pull some more out here. You go all the way to the bottom. There we go. Maybe I just was imagining that it was hard to do. I don't know. I'm losing my thing. And then go back to the middle. This one should be hard. So it's already got a layer in there. And come out the outside on the spine on the other side of that. Oh, shoot. On the other side so that's in the middle. One's on this side, one's on that side. Alrighty, we're not very even here. So let me see what I can do. Well, that's just going to have to be good enough. Yeah, it's perfect. All right, you want to give it just a little bit, not too much of a tug, and then tie it off. I'm just going to do a regular knot. So it looks like that. No big deal. I'm going to take these clips off, which are super cute. All right, before I close it up here, I'm going to go ahead and close this envelope. Whoa, I got stuff flying everywhere. And close this envelope off here. Take those out. But you've seen me put these together already. So I'm going to run a little bit here. And a little bit here. A little bit here. And a little bit there. Just like that. So now that seam binding, even though it's pretty, is now hidden. Oh, you know what I did? I put it in upside down. Oh no. All right, you see I had time to open it up. Did you see that? Well, fiddlesticks. Yep, I've got the whole thing upside down. Dagnummit. Okay. Let's untie it. It's a good thing I didn't go crazy with the knots. See, mistakes can be made very easily when you're not thinking. Okay, come on. I don't know how I did that. Where's my poker thing? Could just get a new piece of seam binding and cut it off, but that seems rather wasteful. Well, come on. Uh-oh. I was getting glued down. I hope my head's not in the way. Uh-oh. I've almost got it. Well, shoot. Yeah, I wonder if I still got you watching this. Good gosh. Good golly. There we go. Ah! I won! Okay. Let's pull this back out. Start over. Let me go ahead and clip this envelope up down so that it doesn't get in the way. Oh, better be careful. No, I'm not doing that either. Alright, so this whole thing needs to flip around. So it needs to be like this. Because there's the pocket. Okay. Alright. Duh. It's just one of those moments. And what I'm going to try to do to line it up is this. Let's see if it's right. It's pretty close. Okay. So be sure you double check to make sure your stuff, if it has pockets in it already, you need to make sure that it's right side up. Okay. Just like that. Let's put these inserts back in here. They don't both have to go in there. You know, you can put one in this pocket right there. Oops. I thought, what in the heck? All right, so there's that. There's an envelope. And I stuck one of those inserts right there. All right, now when you go to, oh, let's not do that yet. So we've got some, we got a couple envelopes. And then we've got a couple pockets too. So let's see. Oh, I can take that off. That was just to keep that flap out of the way. I can take that off. Okay. All right, now let's see. Where could I put a pocket? I think one right here would be good. What do you think? I think that would be good, just right there. Yep. So I'm going to put one right there. All you got to do is, first thing you want to do is you want to tack this bottom flap to the side flap so that when you put something in there, it doesn't get stuck on the on this bottom flap right here. What? Like that. Oh, it's not working. It's supposed to. All right, put a little glue there and a little glue there. Yeah, my little boo-boo's got me all flustered now. Okay. So you just want to line it up the best you can. Oops. Give it a minute to tack. I'm really bad about doing that. It's terrible. Okay, so there's one pocket in there. And then where can we put the other pocket? There's some white space there. Let's use that one. I keep passing it up. Let's put it right here. Like that. Okay. The reason I'm going ahead and doing this is because when you fold it up, you're going to have to work the paper a little bit so that that folds over nicely because it thickens up, of course, once you get everything in. And you don't have to, obviously, you don't have to use every pocket, everything. You don't have to do it at all. Alright, let's see what else we got. I got my cute little side pocket. Let's see, let's put one of these in there. These two pieces that I had for... Maybe. If I didn't glue it correctly. Yeah, it's easier said than done, apparently. There we go. That's cute. Let's put that one back in there, like that. Alright, so now I still have that pocket. I mean, that envelope that needs to go into a pocket. That's already... This has got... Oops, that's upside down. It's got an insert. Hang on, I promise. I'm getting somewhere here. Oh, my phone's got one off. We might put that in there, or, nope, can't put it in that one. Or we could put it in, not that one, this one. Put that there, maybe. That's cute. And then we've got this one. I'm thinking I should put it there with that. Oh no, I've got this tall right here. There. All right, everything's got a space and everything's got an insert. So what you want to do now is, because you see how thick it's gotten? I don't know if you can, I don't know if the lighting's going to let me. No. Oh, my terrible lighting that I got going on today. See how thick it's gotten? So now what we want to do is we want to kind of really give it some elbow grease, just a little bit. And then this flat part, you just want to kind of carefully bend it. And depending on what cardstock you use or what paper you use, it's going to matter on the thickness, obviously, of course. Because see, like this one here, the cardstock isn't as thick. So, you know, the edge here doesn't have to bend as much. Yeah, so you just work with it a little bit. You just work with it. And then you take your ribbon, wrap it around, and tie a bow. Right? And it's just that simple. So it looks like I did have enough after all. So yeah, isn't that cute? You could too, give a little more room in the spine. You might want to ink the holes that you poked there. But yeah, so please let me know what you think. All the links and stuff will be in the description box below. Give me a thumbs up if you like this video. If you have any ideas for me, leave them in the comment section below. And I guess I'll see you next time. Bye.